Happy morning, my dear children. Welcome to Yelga online class. All the time while you are attending the online class, make sure that you have your Yelga book, note, rule pencil, eraser along with you. I will give you 3 seconds time. You have to get ready. 3, 2, 1, and 0. Today we have to cover unit 5 and day 4. In your today's class, let us see the phonation. This past 3 days, we learnt about some vowel digraphs. Do you remember that? Yes. Today, you are going to write a dictation for the phonics. Right? We have to use the letter sounds to read that. Right? In our phonics class. I will show that some words. After, I will hide that. You will write a self-test, okay? Yes, get ready in your phonics note, phonics page, okay? 3, 2, 1, 0. Yes. First one, see the word brief. 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 Start counting. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Yes. Next one, griff. Griff, griff. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Yes. Next, relief, relief, relief. Start counting. 3, 2, 1, 0. Yes. Next word, size, size. Size. Start counting. 3, 2, 1, 0. Yes. Next word. Chimney. 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 My dear children, you have to use the letter sounds to write these words. Right? Chimney. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Yes. Next one, jockey, jockey, jockey. Start counting. 3, 2, 1, 0. Next, alley, alley, alley. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Yes. The last word, valley, valley, valley. Start counting. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Yes. I hope you are all completed your dictation words. Now I will show the answers. Let us check your answers, my dear children. If you make a mistake, you will write 5 times and send it in your WhatsApp group. Check out your answers, my dear children. I will give you 30 seconds time. Great, my dear children. Yes, let us move to the whole words. We learnt about 4 new whole words in our unit 1, right? Let us recap that. After that, we will see the worksheet. We have to use the whole words to write a sentence, right? Yes. What are the whole words we learnt about from this unit? Leaving. 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 We have to use the words as it is. We do not use the letter sounds to read these words, right? How we have to read these words? Left to right. Leaving. Leaving. Stayed. 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 Find. 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 Then, 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 then. So, do you remember this whole words, my dear children? Let us see how we have to use the whole words to fill the worksheets. I will show that. My dear children, this is your worksheet number 4, question number 1. We read that whole words, right? What are the questions? Fill in the blanks with the appropriate words we given below. What are the words? First of all, we have to read these words. Leaving, strayed, find, then. See that? Ravi was dashed for his office. He looks for his key, but he cannot dash them. He looks in the cupboard. He looks under the bed. He looks on the table. He looks for the keys everywhere. He was upset that he was getting late for his office. Dash, he looked at some time, shining in the garden. He saw his son playing with the keys. Ravi told him to give the keys back. The son says, I wish you dash at home today. Ravi smiled and hugged his son. Did you listen this sentence, my dear children? Now we have to find out the words where we have to fill that, okay? Yes, let us see that. See the answers, my dear children. Ravi was leaving for his office. He looks for his keys, but he cannot find them. He looks in the cupboard. He looks under the bed. He looks on the table. He looks for the keys everywhere. He was upset that he was getting late for his office. Then, which word here come? Then, he looked at something shining in the garden. He saw his son playing with the keys. Ravi told him to give the keys back. The son says, I wish you stayed at home today. Ravi smiled and hugged his son. So, this is the answer for this blanks, right? Yes, my dear children, just we have to clarify these answers. You will write the answers from your notebook. After get your workbook, you have to complete this page, okay? Yes. Do you understand, my dear children? Yes. Now, let us move to the reading and listening comprehension session. From today's class, you are going to read the story independently, okay? I will read first. After that, I will send you in WhatsApp group for that story. You will read the story in your home. Okay? Just you have to read them. If you have any struggle means, you have to ask your parents to read that story. Okay? Yes. Wine, fire and paper. Then, adapted from Chinese folk tales. Illustration, Dhanushree Selvi. See the first page. An old man lived in China with his two sons. His sons were married to two sisters. They were living happily in their house. Next page. The two sisters wanted to visit their parents. Before leaving, they took the blessings of the old man. They said, we want to gift you something. What do you want? Get wine and fire wrapped in a paper, he said. The sisters promised to get his gift. See the next page. They stayed for a few days with their parents. Now it was time for them to return, but they could not find the gift for the old man. They asked many people, but they could not help them. People said, wine will blow the paper and fire will burn the paper. Next page. The two sisters started crying. Just then, a woman came to help them. She said, I can't put wine and fire in a paper. Next page. First, she made a paper fan. Then she made a paper box and put a lamp inside it. Right? The old man was surprised to receive these gifts. So this is the story from your RC class, right? Yes. Did you listen to the story, my dear children? Yes. How did the sister solve the problem? A woman came and helped them in making the gifts, right? Yes. It was because of the woman that they were able to solve the problem. Had she not been there in the story, the old man would not have received his gifts, right? Do you understand from the story, my dear children? Yes. See that, my dear children. I'll write this. How did the other woman helping find the gifts? The other woman does. So you are going to write this sentence in your notebook and complete the sentence. Just you have to refer to your SR book, okay? Yes. Now, my dear children, I will show the worksheet number 4, question number 2. Okay, you will write the answers for this questions in fun sentences, okay? You have to just go through the SR book, okay? Yes, write the answers. I will show that now. See that we read that story, right? Yes. See the first question. Where did the old man live? Where did the old man live? Next question. What did he want as a gift? The third question. What gift did he get at the end? Let us see the answers now, my dear children. What is the question? Where did the old man live? The old man lived in China. My dear children, this question and answers I will send you in WhatsApp. You will write down the answers in your notebook. Just go through the answers and also you have to understand the answers, okay? Where did the old man live? The old man lived in China. What is the next question? What did he want as a gift? What is the next question? What did he want as a gift? He wanted wine and fire wrapped in a paper as a gift. This is the second question answer. Next, what gift did he get at the end? What gift did he get at the end? See the answer, my dear children. He got a paper lamp and a paper fan at the end. Once again, he got a paper lamp and a paper fan at the end. So this is the answer for this 3 questions. You have to write down your notebook, okay? Let us see the 4th question. What do you think is the meaning of the word leaving? Leaving means we have to go somewhere from your place to another place. Leaving means what? We have to go away. Right? To go away. This is the meaning of the word for leaving. Right? Yes. Let us see the next question. What do you think is the meaning of the word wrapped? Wrapped means what? To pack in a piece of paper. To pack in a piece of paper. This is the answer for this. Okay? Yes, my dear children. You have to write in your rough note from this reading and listening comprehension section page 5 questions. Okay? Yes. My dear children, the sisters promised to get this gift. What is the meaning by promised? Do you know that? What is the meaning by promised? Yes, want to give a? Agree, I will promise you. I will give you confirmly like that, right? Yes. You have to say one something word. Great, promised. I have promised to my mother that I will drink milk every day. Right? What is the sentence? I have promised to my mother that I will drink milk every day. Right? So, my dear children, this like I will write two words from this related words. You have to try to read and write one sentences. Okay? See that. Blessings, blessings, wrapped, wrapped. You have to try to write one sentences from this word, okay? This related, okay? You have to make a sentence from this words and send it in our ELGA 8 group. Do you understand, my dear children, from this RC class? Yes. Yeah, great, my dear children. Let us move to the grammar part. In our grammar part, we learnt about a countable and uncountable nouns, right? We have to go through that quantity words. What is that? Quantity words. We have to revise that after we have to go to the next one. Quantity words tell us how much or how many of something is there. See that? Quantity words. Much, little, some. These are all the uncountable nouns. If it is an uncountable noun, means we have to use this quantity words, right? See the examples. There is a little milk left in the jug. Little, this is a quantity word. Milk is a uncountable noun, so we have to use this quantity word, little. Next, how much jam have you put? Jam. Jam is an uncountable noun, so we have to use the quantity word much. Next one. Please give me some water. Water. Is it a countable or uncountable? Yes. Is it a uncountable noun? So we have to use some. So uncountable noun means we have to use this quantity words. What are that? Much, little, some, right? Yes. Next, let us move to the countable nouns. Countable noun means we have to count. For example, pens, sticks, rule pencils, fan, like that. If there is a countable noun, means we have to use this quantity words. Few, many, some. What is that? Few, many, some. See the examples. There are a few books on the table. There are a few books on the table. Here, books is a noun, so it is a countable noun. So we have to use the quantity word few. Next, how many pens do you need? Where it is a noun? Yes. Pen is a noun, so we have to use many quantity word, right? Next, I have some notes in my wallet. Notes is a noun, we have to count, so we have to use the quantity word some, right? So do you understand, my dear children, which word we have to use? That uncountable means we have to use much, little, some. Countable means we have to use few, many, some. Just we have to identify the nouns if it is a countable or uncountable. After that, you have to use this quantity words. Okay? Yes. See this, my dear children. This is your workbook. Workbook number 5, question number 2. Tick a correct word from the absence given. Quantity words. See the picture. Mangoes. If it is a countable or uncountable? Yes. If it is a countable noun, which word you have to use that? Few, right? Yes. Next, apple. Apple is a countable or uncountable? Countable noun. So we have to use a few. Next, what is that picture? Bun. Many of much. Which word you have to use? Very good, my dear children. Many. Next, what is that? I think so. Potatoes. Many or some? We have to discuss the answers now. Next, grapes. Few or some? If it is a countable or uncountable? Yes. Next, little, many. Right. Yes. So you have to write your grammar note. Write a picture name. After that, you put a dash. Which one? Countable or uncountable? Which one? Quantity. Which quantity? Few or much? Let us discuss the answers. See this. Few. There are few mangoes. Next, countable noun apple. So we have to tick the few. Next, jam. Many. Countable noun. Next, this is a potato. We have to use many and some. This is also countable nouns. Next, grapes. We have to use few. Next, vegetables. There are many vegetables is there. So we have to use the word many. Let us move to the next worksheet. See this. This is also you have to write your notebook, my dear children. Fill in the blanks with the correct word from the options given. There are dash fruits in the baskets. Where is the noun? Fruit is a noun. So which word you have to use? Countable noun means which quantity word we have to use? Yes, few. We have to use few. There are few fruits in the basket. Next, he has dash balls around him. So which one is the noun? Balls. So which word we have to use? Yes. It is a countable noun. So we have to use many. Next, how dash cars can you see here? Which is the noun? Cars. So which word you have to use? Great, my dear children. Yes, many. He has dash pens of different colors. You have to identify the noun. After that, you have to write the answer here. Yes, pens is a noun. It is a countable noun. So we got to use many. Next, there are dash candles on the cake. Candles is a noun. Which word here come? Countable noun. Few. So this one you have to write the answers and send it in your group. Okay. I'll send this question tomorrow. Yes. So my dear children, from that workbook you will write the question. Write the answers. You only try to. I said already. But what did you learn? I don't know. That's why you have to write the answer and send it in the group. Okay. Yes. Let us move to our writing and speaking expression skill. So till now, we have written 5 or 8 sentences for our stories. Did you write that? Yes. Today, we will work on improving these sentences. This is called enhancing. What is that? Enhancing. That means a good writer always enhances his story after the first draft. Today, we will follow these steps to improve our sentences. Right? Yes. Cubs strategy. What is that? Cubs strategy. I will show that. See that, my dear. Capital letters for the first letter, proper nouns I. You have to use the capital letter in the first letter. You have while you are starting that, you have to use the capital letters, okay? Yes, next. Use the sentence structure to write sentences, okay? Beginning, middle, end, that like you have to use the sentence structures to write the sentences. Next, put a full stop and one finger space between the words. This is also you know about, right? Put a full stop and one finger space between the words. Next, spelling are all correct and written beautifully. So you have to use cup strategy from your sentences or stories. Okay. Yes. So, my dear children, once again, you have to take your notebook, writing and speaking expressions page. What did you write from your yesterday's class? Just you have to go through it. If you are right correctly or not. What is that? First letter is the capital letter. You have to start every sentences. After that, you have to complete the sentence. Beginning, middle and end sound. Okay, after that if you complete one sentence mean you have to put a full stop. After that you will write one word. After next you are going to write a next word means you put a one finger space to write. These are all the rules for the CUPS strategy. The last one, spellings are correct or not. Just you have to check out your answers. If you are make a mistake means you have to write neatly and send it in our group. What did you write about Cinderella's story? Okay, yeah? This is the writing and speaking expression session from today's class. Okay, my dear children. So, what did we learn today's class? Shall we recap that? Yes, vowel digraphs. You wrote a dictation some words. Next, whole words. We recap that four whole words. And we have to complete the worksheet. Then reading and listening comprehension session. Again, you are going to read the independent reading. After that, you have to complete the worksheets. This and all you have to write in your notebook now. Okay. After you have to get your workbook and book, you have to complete that. Next, grammar part. Quantitative words. We have to recap that and we have to use that word. We have completed the worksheets. Next, writing and speaking expressions. We used the CUPS strategy to write our sentences. This one you have to see your notebook if you used or not. If you not used means you are not used means you have to write now. Okay, send it in our group, my dear children. Bye. Thank you. Happy learning. Be safe.